Hello, welcome to SAS Explorer. I'm Bill Danker, the product manager for SAS Viya with SingleStore. In this session, we're going to introduce and talk about SAS Viya with SingleStore and show you a hands-on demo of our new offering. What we'll start out with, though, is just talking about the product itself, SAS Viya with SingleStore. SingleStore is a relational database management system that is ANSI standard SQL compliant with very strong compression and encryption capabilities built in. What's more exciting is SingleStore's ability to handle row store, column store, and object storage in one database, in one table. Essentially, it allows companies to support transactional processes while at the same time having the data stored in columnar structure that enables complex analytical workloads to be run simultaneously. There is great potential here to reduce data movement, data duplication, and enable the application of sophisticated SAS models in real time against that data to support complex decision making. With that, as SingleStore is our background, let's talk about how we're going to combine that with SAS Viya. Let's have a look at our current SAS Viya high-level architecture and how it works today. You can see here standard SAS datasets, relational databases, and other cloud repositories that are all part of an enterprise data fabric. Along the top, we have our traditional compute engine, and next to that, a picture of our advanced AI machine learning cloud analytic service, or CAS, engine, where we read and move data around within our CAS node pool, utilizing our in-memory distributed layer architecture. I want to talk a little bit about our traditional in-database technologies. On the left, we have a DBMS composed of a cluster of machines. On the right, we have CAS, which is composed of a controller and worker machines and lots of memory to hold data in memory. SAS procs can generate SQL and submit it to the database in order to, one, reduce data on the network by operating on the data close to where it is stored, and take advantage of capabilities in the database's SQL processor. We also do barrel data transfer. This is where machines in the database connect directly to CAS workers for bidirectional data transfer. There's a green dot in the database diagram. That is the SAS embedded process, or EP. The EP is a process that can run SAS software. We use it to run SAS generated models for scoring accelerator, for example. And we also use it to perform parallel data transfer with CAS. With all database loads, however, into CAS, we store a copy of the data in CAS before we operate on it. This means all subsequent model development and dashboarding operate on an HDAT memory mapped copy of the data. Now I'd like to show you what is changing. The first thing you'll notice is we've combined the CAS and database diagrams into one. Both CAS and SingleStore run close to each other in the same Kubernetes namespace. In the top of the diagram, we have CAS with a controller and several workers. Notice we have less workers than we had before because we are leveraging the SingleStore cluster. In the bottom of the diagram, we have the SingleStore cluster, which uses leaf nodes for basic table operations and aggregators for more complex operations that require combining data from multiple leaves. Like traditional in-database, we support procs generating SQL and pushing it down to SingleStore as well as parallel data transfer. In addition to that, we have the new SAS embedded process running in the leaf nodes. Our initial release targets our visual applications like Visual Analytics. A visual apps invoke CAS actions and utilize WHERE clauses, and the WHERE clauses use computed columns. To improve performance, we push down the WHERE clause and computed columns to the EP in SingleStore to subset rows in the database instead of in CAS. Instead of making a copy in memory, we stream the data in parallel as needed for SingleStore from SingleStore to CAS. This might seem mundane, but is a core feature for our new offer. We've separated the compute cluster, CAS, from the data cluster, SingleStore. This allows us means if you need more or less compute, you add or remove CAS workers. If you need more or less data, you add or remove single store aggregators and leaves. CAS scalability has historically been tied to the size of your data need. That is no longer the case with SAS Viya with SingleStore. With that as a background then, let's go ahead and move into a hands-on demo. I'm going to show you an import of about 1.4 million rows with a SingleStore pipeline, and then we'll jump into Viya using Visual Analytics and Model Builder to build some graphs, some dashboards, and some models. First, what I'd like to do is jump into SingleStore Studio, and what I've set up here is a pipeline. I've got a file of taxicab data that I have. It's sitting out in a Parquet data set in AWS, and I'd like to bring that into my SingleStore database so I can operate on it. First thing I need to do then is create the table. So I've already set up all the commands here to help with the timing on our demo. So that created the table. Next, I need to create the pipeline and connect it to my Parquet data set. So create pipeline. You'll see here's the data set. It's sitting in S3 on AWS. There's the region. I can then roll down, and of course right here you can see that it's a Parquet table. What I'd like to do now then is go ahead and run that pipeline and then take that data from AWS, bring it into Azure, which is where my SingleStore database sits, and get it loaded. In this particular case, I've transferred about 1.4, 1.37 million rows. You've seen that run in real time. Looks like it took about 4.5 seconds. So this is just demonstrating the ability of the pipelining tools with SingleStore to move lots of data quickly into SingleStore tables, repositories for use then with Viya. With that then, let's jump over and have a look at SAS Viya. I'm going to start out with another way of getting data into SingleStore. Here I've got a set of weather data, public data I've downloaded from NASA. 5 years I've done a lot of work in agriculture over the years, so I like working with weather data. This is a data prep job I've set up in SAS Viya. I've got the NASA data set here. I've got a few steps that I've built. I've added a unique identifier, calculated a column called heat units, and then I've converted another column. What I want to show quickly though, however, is when you go to run this data job, having it load the data into a single store table is very easy. In this particular case, I've got a CasLib library. It actually is the single store database. S2 ST prod is the name we have here. The target table name, NASA, my weather data is from 2017 to 2021, and S2 is short for single store. So it literally, it's that easy. You pick your database, you say, here's the table I want to create, and then you run your job. From that, let's go over then and explore and visualize that same set of data. So we'll have a look at it. Here's the, that's my other data set. Let's pick on the NASA data set. So here's the data set. I've added an additional column before jumping into this demo called date. The original data set did not have a date in it, had month, day, and year. So just demonstrating for you the ability to build on the fly additional columns into your relational table, into your single store table. I've also added GIS variable as well. Let's go ahead and then build a couple of objects. Let's start out with the GIS one. Since I created that variable, let's do a coordinate map. I want to see what I've got for data. Where are we at here? All right, there is my GIS variable, and let's go ahead and take a look at precipitation. That's good enough for now. I'm going to take this little chart. I'm going to throw it over here onto the side. Position that a little bit, maybe make it a little bit bigger. And so we can see here, I'm going to go ahead and play with this a little bit more. Bring up the options. Whoops, clicking too fast here. go down and let's take the legend off just so I get a little bit more zoomed in on my map. So I live here in North Carolina, so that's a data set that I pulled down. We can see here a lot of precipitation along the coast, a little bit more up in the mountains. Okay, so that's one view, and to point out here, I'm working directly with a relational table in SingleStore. This is no longer a SAS HDAT or a BDAT file that you're working in within Viya. Let's do something else. Let's go ahead and do a dual access bar chart. I'm going to pull that over here and throw it across the bottom. All right, let's position this a little bit. Over here to the left, and then we'll stretch this out across the bottom. And let's assign some data. So again, this is going against the relational table. I'm going to grab that date field, because that's what I want to look at. I want to look at things over time. Let's go ahead and look at that precipitation variable again. And let's look at that other column that I created, heat units. And I'll close that off. All right, so we've got a new chart up. And again, so we're working directly with the data in the single store table, getting a chance to have you look at performance. That chart looks kind of funny to me, and I suspect I know why, because it's not sorting on the date. So let's go ahead and sort it. So that will reissue the query, brings the data back. And now I get what I expected to see. I expected to see the heat units in a yearly cycle, getting warm in the summer, cold in the winter. And then we see along the bottom precipitation falling through here. I want to do one more thing here. Let's go ahead and put a filter on here that we can play with. We'll do a button bar. Here we go. Let's see. I'm going to look at, let's look at it by year. And we'll put this up here so it's a little more easy to see and grab a hold of. So, now, as I'm looking at the data, let's say I'm interested in this spike of precipitation here. Let's look, that's 2018. We'll click on that. So zoomed in right here, the GIS map refreshed. My gradient boost algorithm also refreshed, reran our analytics on it. And it's telling me that in terms of heat units, the variables that seem to have the most import to predicting it are photosynthetic activity and our all sky clearness. I also was able to zoom in down below all of this running basically SQL queries against that relational table, all coming back and letting me play with the data as I would with the normal HDAT or SDAT files or BDAT files. So all of the power of Viya, and now you can execute things directly against an ANSI standard SQL table. One more thing I want to show real quick. Let's go ahead and go to Model Manager where we've built some models. We'll take a look at the data itself just to show you again, this is that same relational table sitting in single store. There's all my data values. I've created several pipelines looking at different ways to analyze the data. I can run those pipelines again in real time against the data. I can then, when they're completed, take a look at the pipeline comparison. In this particular case of all of those different models that I ran, linear regression was the winner. That really doesn't surprise me, given that the heat units is a calculation based on some of the variables. So not surprising the linear regression won here. But the point again in all of this in the demo is highlighting for you the fact that you can now run, you can build your models against relational tables directly. You can train them, have them ready to go. You can then use the output to populate a dashboard and have it ready to go. So really looking at speeding the time from getting your data to being able to analyze it and then interpret it and give decisions back to your business. With that then, let's go back to our presentation. So we've done the import. Hopefully you like what you saw in terms of working with Viya, working directly with SingleStore. I want to thank you for your time and I hope this was informative. And if you have any additional information, again, this is Bill Danker, product manager here at SAS.